All right, I'm creating this video to show you how to create a macro button that will save and close a workbook in Microsoft Excel. There's only a couple easy steps if you want to follow along. I'm in a fresh sheet right now. And the first thing you want to have to be able to add a button to your worksheet is the developer tab here. And to be able to get this, it's really easy. You just go to the Excel options and find the ribbon options and check the box that will enable this tab to appear. Once you have that, you can come over here to insert and insert this form control button here. And to do that, you just have to click on it and then drag with your left mouse button the size of the button that you want to put in. Okay, and this will appear. Now, by default, the name for my button is button one. And I could record a macro here, but I just want to add some code that I'll actually put in the description so that you can paste it in. Clicking this will allow me to add some code in a new window. And let's see, let me find the code. Just a little bit of code put in here. I'll paste it right in here. Just have to get rid of this because the first line that was in there is an accurate description of my button's name. Got too many of these. All right, so that's the code that I need. Like I said, you can just pick it out of the description. Just make sure that you use the first line, which will designate, this is going to be the name correlating the code to your button, or the macro to your button. So now that I have my code in, all I need to do is save the document. If it wasn't previously saved, it's gonna ask me to save in a location. So I'm just gonna call it a macro button. Save it as desktop, but I wanna make sure I save it as a macro enabled workbook so that my macro will work. And once I save this, it should be good to go. And to test it, it's already saved now, but I'm gonna add some data in here just to see if it saves. I'm gonna hit the button. It should close the workbook. I'll go find the workbook for my desktop and make sure that these two cells save this jibber jabber that I added into these cells. So this should close. All right. Now I want to go look at my desktop. There's the file. Open it up. This is really the only test that I want to do. It's just taking a while to open. And there we go. And then every time that you open this document up, you just have to make sure that you enable the content. This is just you telling Excel that you trust the macro content. And that's it. Thanks for watching.